All right, you guys, so today we're also going to be installing, I forgot what these are called, but these go on the vents in the front. So basically, I was able to get the front one off on the driver's side. I'm going to show you guys right now what it looks like. It's literally three screws. It's super, just got to get the right tool for it. So basically, for this, the screws go right here. See, as you can see, the three slots, and they kind of hook into the corner, so it kind of hooks into there just like that. Let me show you guys. So right here, three screws go right in here, see that, right over there in the corner up there, and they hook right into these slots, so it just literally goes right in there. So the new one we're gonna put in right now, so this is the carbon flash one. We'll put the carbon one. I think it looks a lot nicer. I got this from Extreme Online again. They hooked me up with a nice carbon fiber one, which is gonna look way sexier than the other ones. As you can see, it looks way better than that one. And that's what we need. So that one needs to look more gangster-ish. So this is a very easy install. So I don't know if I can really hold this and do this at the same time, but basically you just slide it in right here, just like this, and it goes right in. It's very easy. And you put the screws in. These are the screws right here. I think they were 10 millimeters. Very easy, super duper easy. Just slide your finger in there and twist them into the holes right here, and they go right through these slots. It's very easy. And then hook them. See the little hooks on the side? They go right into the slots right here. It's very easy. Oh, my bad. All right, you guys, so I got one screw in, so you guys can see how this works. You literally take, I believe it's a 10 millimeter, and you put it right in here. Yeah, come closer so they can see here. So you put it right along the side right here, and you just twist it, and it comes right out. So just keep doing that until it comes out. It's pretty much loose. And then it'll be loose enough to where you can just use your hand like that. Make sure to not drop this inside your bumper, because or else you're gonna have to unscrew everything from the bottom. There you go. There you go. See that noise? That's the good noise you want. Alright. Keep going. That's it. Pretty much you just pull it out from the side, and then you're pretty much done. And then just do the same thing. When you having trouble with the wrench, you can take a piece of it right here and just do it with your hand. It's so much easier after you have already loosened it. It's a little easy trick to use. If you cannot reach all the way in there and you're tired of twisting your whole finger forever. Sorry, it's just a weird angle. So just get in there and just twist like that. It should come right out. This side. See, I think the proper way you're supposed to do this is take the whole bumper off, but it's usually easier if you know what you're doing. And if you have skinny hands, this is actually a very easy job. My hands are fat. Like my dogs. There you go. Alright, so this side's out. Make sure to always carry the screw so it doesn't fall out. There you go. Okay, I'm gonna do this one real quick. Let's see. My nose running. Got my face over here. Woo! Man, that would really help if you have some small hands. There we go. Alright, we got this one out too. So this is going to be the part I'm going to show you that you need to see on how to take this out. Oh, don't drop the screw, man. Don't drop the screw. There you go. Okay, so pretty much comes out like this. It's kind of in there, so you kind of push this way, see how it came out? And there's hooks in here, so you kind of have to like pry it out this way. Yep. Come a little closer. Come closer up here, you can see how they hook in here. It's kind of like, kind of work your way. You don't want to push too hard because you don't want to break no tabs or anything. And it comes right off, just like that. Real easy. And then you get your new one, which is the carbon fiber one, and you're gonna take all these off right here with a flathead. So those come off real easy. You just slide them off. Some you could take off with your finger, see? Pretty easy. And then you put them on the new one in the same spot, line them up, and put it back on with the same screws. Do it at your home job, real easy. No mathematics, no diploma, because I ain't got that, and I did this, and my fingers hurt.
Come a little closer so you can see this. Right off, just push it a little bit. There you go. Okay. Bow. Now we're gonna put these onto the new ones. So this is the new one here. So when you do this, you want this to be facing outward like this. And slide them on because you're gonna have the screws come through here, so you're gonna want this to be on the outside, or it's not gonna work. So put those on there real quick. Real easy. And now come over here, you can come on this side, see a little bit. Now you just slide the hooks so you can see little slots. Slide the hooks right in there, just like so. Very easy. Make sure they all line through the slots so you don't break nothing. There you go. See, they should slide right in. There's just a certain point where you just gotta push it in, and then it'll just all go in easily, and then that's it. Now I just gotta put the screws in to hold it, and we'll be good to go. If I can find the other screw. Oh my gosh, where's the other screw? I don't have it. All right, I'm just going to put these in right now. Remember, put them in the back. Do not drop these. All right, so you're going to have to pick your whole bumper off to find it, and or you're just going to leave it in there, and then your whole car is going to make a noise the rest of your life. And no one got time for that. And like I said, if you want to tighten them and your fingers are hurting or whatever, you can use this, something like this. Put them on the back. Twist it up just enough to get it to tighten. See, it's going right through. Very easy. Don't tighten them all the way, so just go a little bit, just so you can work around and move it a little bit still. And then after that, you can tighten them all up. And there you have it. It's easy install. I'm going to show you guys what it looks like on both sides at the end, and we'll be all good to go.
This right here is facing outward so that you can screw it. Or you can do the opposite. I'm going to do it the same way as the stock one, where you put it on the outside and you screw it from the inside. So, let's do it. Okay. Yeah. Very easy. Done. All right. There you go. Easy squeezy. My nose. So, this tool helps a lot. You're going to need one of these damn tools. But this is what you need right here. That's it. And this thing right here. That ratchet. Make sure you get one of those. This allows you to turn it at a certain angle. Makes it so much easier. And yeah, that's pretty much it. You might need one of these just to get these sliders off. To put the new ones in there, and that's it. Slides right in. Very easy install. Looks super sick. Thank you, Extreme Online, for your guys's carbon fiber accessories. Looking super good on the CA. Make sure you guys check out their website. I'm gonna put the link below. Definitely got some cool stuff. Can't wait to put on the front splitter. They're gonna send me a carbon fiber one too. It's gonna be really sick. Looks super clean. Oh my gosh, I can't wait to see it in the sunlight.